Hi children, good morning. Good morning to all of you. See children, see here. Yesterday we discussed about what is the ionization energy and what are the units of ionization energy and what is the definition of ionization energy. Hi children. So today we are going to discuss about what are the factors affecting on ionization energy. So before I am going to discuss about factors affecting on ionization energy. See children, when I'm explaining about types of atomic radii, so before that I'm explaining two factors. What is that? Screening effect or sealing effect, and one more that is a nuclear charge. Right children? So there small mistake is there. What is that means? Here before I said I think so. Sigma star equals to Z minus sigma is children. Right children, this is the wrong children. So what is the correct one means? Z star equals to Z minus sigma. Z minus sigma. Here Z star is the effective nuclear charge. Z is the atomic number, and sigma is the screening constant. Right children, it is the correct one children. So please, according to this, we need to solve the sums based on Slater's rule. Right children. Already I sent a lot of 2 or 3 videos for Slater's rule, how we had find out the effective nuclear charge for different atoms. I'm already sending. Right children, please once again you have to open that link and you have to listen that classes and you have to understand. Right children. So now coming to the factors affecting on ionization energy. See children, what is meant by factors affecting on ionization energy means here. On ionization energy, some factors are affecting children. What are those factors means? The first one is atomic size. First one is atomic size. And the second one is nuclear charge. What children? Nuclear charge. And the third one is here screening effect or sealing effect. And the fourth one is half field or full field electronic configuration. Okay children, then fifth one is penetration power. What you mean? Penetration power. And the last one is oxidation step. What you mean? Oxidation step. So these are the factors can be affecting on ionization energy. Right children? So first we have to go to discuss about how the atomic size can be varied in ionization energy. How the atomic size will be affecting on ionization energy. Right children? So we have discussed about that. See children, here when we are taking the ionization energy, see here the minimum amount of energy is required to remove the electron from the valence cell of the neutral gaseous atom is called as ionization. Already we know the definition. Right children, see here when we are observing this, the first factor that is the atomic size. Right children? So what is meant by atomic size children? The distance between nucleus to where the valence electron is present in the valence cell. That means here, suppose when we are moving from top to bottom in groups, what will happen? Here, this is the atomic size. Then here, number of cells are increases. Automatically the atomic size is gradually increases from top to bottom in the groups. Right children? See children, so this we have to consider the atomic size. So in common we have to consider the atomic radius. What's the radius of the atom? See children, here it's very very less radius. Here from top to bottom groups atomic size is, from top to bottom in groups atomic size is increases children. Sorry, here atomic size is increases. Why the atomic size is increases from top to bottom in groups means because of number of cells are increases. When the number of cells are increases means automatically number of atomic number is increases. Atomic number is increases means number of cells are increases. When the number of cells are increases means number of
inner electrons also increases.
So number of inner electrons and increases means these inner electrons can be acting as a sealant.
That means
here when the atomic size is increased, why the atomic size is increased means from nucleus to valence cell the distance is increases. Due to that reason, the force of attractions are decreases.
Force of attractions are decreases.
Here it's a nucleus, it is a valence electron. The distance is very closer, that means it is having more force of attractions. But here the distance between nucleus and valence electron, some more large distance between compared to first atom. Let's say here we have some more less force of attraction. Here the distance is very high, that's why the force of attractions are gradually decreases from top to bottom. Force of attractions are decreases. So force of attractions are decreases means the valence electron does not come closer to the nucleus. Does not come closer to the nucleus means because of here these are the inner electrons can be acting as a screening effect or sealing effect. That means from top to bottom in groups, sealing effect is increases. Why the atomic size increases means because the force of attractions are decreases, sealing effect is increases. And from top to bottom in groups, here the atomic size is increases means the electron does not come closer to the nucleus. That's why gradually the nuclear charge is also decreases. When the nuclear charge is decreases means here the atomic size is increases means suppose if you want to remove the electron from here to here, it is having force of attractions and more. Suppose if you want to remove the one electron means it requires some more energy. But see children, here the distance is very high. The distance is very high means compared with this atom requires some more less energy. Suppose if we can take this atom, the distance between nucleus to valence electron is very high. That's why suppose if you want to remove the electron from the third atom means it requires very less energy. So from here to here, the distance between nucleus and valence electron is very far. That's why to remove the electron it requires some more less energy. That means from top to bottom in groups, when the force of attractions are decreases means here automatically the ionization energy is decreases. Right children? See here, suppose if you can take the one of the magnet. This is the north pole, this is the south pole. Suppose if you can take this one of the iron pin or iron nail. See what will happen, suppose it is very near to the magnet means the attractive forces are very high. Suppose if you remove this pin, it requires some more energy. Otherwise, suppose if we can take this magnet, here the pin is there. Here which one requires some more energy children? It requires more energy, it requires less energy. Same thing here also. Here because the force of attractions are more means to remove the electron is very difficult. That's why it requires some more energy. But when the force of attractions are very, very, very less means to remove the electron also it requires very, very less energy. That's why from top to bottom in groups, if the atomic size is increases means here the ionization energy is decreases. See children, atomic size is increases means ionization energy is decreases. That means atomic size is increases means ionization energy is decreases. And same thing here, screening effect from top to bottom groups, screening effect is increases. So screening effect is increases means ionization energy is decreases. That means children, the first factor is atomic size is inversely proportional to the ionization energy. Atomic size is inversely proportional to the ionization energy. If the atomic size is increases means ionization energy is decreases. Right children? And the same thing, here screening effect is increases means ionization energy is decreases. Here also, here screening effect is inversely proportional to the ionization energy. And children, nuclear charge is decreases means here ionization energy also decreases. Ionization energy also decreases means here nuclear charge is directly proportional to the ionization energy. Since in the first three factors I am saying here, atomic size is inversely proportional to the ionization energy, spinning effect is inversely proportional to the ionization energy, nuclear charge is inversely proportional to the ionization energy. Excellent. So now this is about from top to bottom in group. What about from left to right in periods? What about from left to right in periods? So what about left to right in periods means, so children, here from left to right in periods, the atomic size is gradually, what will happen children? The atomic size is gradually decreases. Why it decreases? Because of the number of cells remain constant, number of valence electrons are increases, number of hidden electrons remain constant. That's why from left to right in periods, the nuclear charge, here the atomic size is decreases means, then the force of attractions are increases. Force of attractions are decreases. Here children, sorry, atomic size is decreases means force of attractions are increases. Suppose if you want to remove the from electron from nucleus to valence electron means, it requires energy. Suppose if you want to remove the electron from here, it's the atomic size decrease means the force of attractions are increases. The force of attractions are increases means suppose if you want to remove the one electron, it's very very difficult to write. That's why here suppose if we can take here lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine. Comparing these all atoms, which is the atom requires some more energy means fluorine required more energy rather than oxygen. Oxygen requires more energy than nitrogen. This is commonly general, we have to say that. Right children? So, in this particular case, what will happen children? Here, fluorine requires more energy rather than these all atoms. That's why fluorine having more ionization energy because of the force of attractions are very high. The force of attractions are very high. The force of attractions are very high means to remove the one electron is very, very difficult children. It's very, very difficult. That's why here from left to right in periods, force of attractions are increases means the screening effect is decreases. Screening effect is decreases means all the electrons are comes near to the nuclear. That's why nuclear charge is increases. Nuclear charge is increases. And force of attractions are increases means makes all electrons are coming close to each other. Then to remove the electrons is very, very difficult. That's why from left to right in periods, ionization energy is increases. Excellent. So from left to right in periods, ionization energy is increases. That means what is the relation children? Atomic size is decreases means ionization energy is increases. Force of attractions are increases means ionization energy is increases. Screening effect is decreases means ionization energy is increases. Nuclear charge is increases means ionization energy also increases. So ionization energy increases means atomic size decreases. These two are inversely proportional to each other. Force of attractions are increases means ionization energy also increases. That means force of attractions are directly proportional to the ionization energy. Screening effect is decreases means ionization energy is increases. These two are inversely proportional. And nuclear charge increases means ionization energy is increases. These two are directly proportional. These two are directly proportional. See children, these are the three factors can be affecting on ionization energy. And the next three factors, what are the next three factors mean? See children, Suppose if you can take nitrogen. What is the electronic configuration of nitrogen today? The electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. That is 2s2, 2p3. Here, in case of 2p3, we have 3 electrons. That means, we have to consider
half field electronic configuration. What's your name? Half field electronic configuration. Half field electronic configuration and full field electronic configuration has more stable children. Right?
Suppose if you can take neon. Here the electronic configuration of neon is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Here, sorry, 2p6. In case of 2p orbital, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 electrons are there. So, whether half field electronic configuration or full field electronic configuration has more stable electronic configuration. So, from more stable electronic configuration, it means suppose if you want to remove the one electron from the one atom, it is very, very difficult. It requires more energy. Since you can compare with nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon. Nitrogen, oxygen. Since then, here electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1, carbon is 1s2s2, 2p. Electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Here electronic configuration of oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. That means here we have half filled electrons are there. Here we have only 2 electrons. Here we have 4 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Compared to nitrogen and oxygen, here when we compare the first ionization energy of nitrogen and oxygen, means the nitrogen requires more energy rather than oxygen because of it is having half the electronic configuration. Compared to nitrogen or carbon requires very less energy. But we take these two examples, nitrogen and oxygen. Here, suppose if you want to remove the first electron from nitrogen and oxygen, nitrogen requires more energy rather than oxygen. That's why IE1 of nitrogen is more than that of IE1 of oxygen. IE1 of oxygen. After remove the one electron from nitrogen and after remove the one electron from the oxygen, means now suppose if you want to remove the electron from the nitrogen and suppose if you want to remove the electron from the oxygen, means which one requires more energy, children? Now, IE2 of oxygen, it requires more energy because it is having half field electronic configuration. It is having commonly 2 electrons are there. That's why IE2 of nitrogen is less than that of IE2 of oxygen. Because of here, the data suppose you want to remove the 1 electron from the IE1 of oxygen, means it requires more energy rather than nitrogen. See, it's very, very important to know. IE1 of nitrogen is greater than that of IE1 of oxygen. But IE2 of nitrogen is less than that of IE2 of oxygen. This is about one of the half field and full field electronic configuration. In case of half field and full field electronic configuration, those are the atoms require more energy compared to other atoms. Right, children? This is about one of the factors. Right, children? So now coming to the fifth factor, that is penetration power. What to mean? Penetration power. So what is meant by penetration power? Means, children, when you are comparing the atom, here first cell, second cell, third cell. First cell having s orbital, second cell having s and p orbital, third cell having s, p, d orbital, fourth cell having s, p, d, f orbital. That means when you compare the s, p, d, f orbitals, means which is the orbital is near the nucleus, means s orbital is near to the nucleus. Then p orbital. P orbital is near to the nucleus rather than d orbital. D orbital is very near to the nucleus rather than f orbital. Then which is the orbital require more energy to remove the electron, means s orbital require more energy rather than p orbital. Yeah, p orbital require more energy rather than d orbital. D orbital require more energy rather than f orbital. That means because of s orbital is very close to the nuclear, thus it requires more energy. So this is about one of the factors, that is the penetration power. Penetration how the conservation power can be affecting on hydrogen energy means the required more energy and other clear because that is very reality we can supply with the big deep and your apartment. That's the children. It is about one of the factor penetration power. Next, last factor that is the oxidation state. What's again? Oxidation state. In case of oxidation state, suppose if we can consider one of the atom. What's the name? Aluminium. Here, in case of aluminium, aluminium having 13 electrons. And Al plus 1, this having 12 electrons. Al plus 2, how many electrons are there? 11. Al plus 3, it is having 10 electrons. Here, it is having more atomic size. When we are losing one electron, then what will happen to them? Here, when the oxidation state is increases, means the atomic size is decreases. When the atomic size is decreases, means to remove the electron is very, very difficult. To remove the electron is very, very difficult. That's why Al plus 3 requires more energy than Al plus 2. Al plus 2 requires more energy than Al plus 1. That's why here, when the increasing the oxidation state means here the required ionization energy also increases. Right, children? That's why here oxidation state is directly proportional to the ionization energy. Right, children? These are the six factors can be affecting on ionization energy. First one, atomic size. And the second one is the spinning effect. Third one about nuclear charge. Fourth one about the half and two-field electronic configuration. And the fifth one about penetration power. It's all about oxidation state. And see children, what I'm saying here, from what is the variation of ionization energy in periods and groups, means in groups from top to bottom in group, atomic size is increases means, ionization energy is decreases. From left to right in periods, the atomic size is decreases means, atomic size is decreases means ionization energy is increased. Based on what we are seeing here ionization energy is inversely proportional to the atomic size. Right, children? This is about what is the variation of ionization energy in periods and groups. Here in groups, ionization energy is decreases. In periods, ionization energy is increased. Right, children? So, this is about one of the periodic properties, that is the ionization energy. Right, children? This is the complete information about ionization energy. And in your textbook, they are given some values also. What is the ionization energy for different atoms? Once all of you look at your textbook, children. Okay? So, please, all of you, watch my videos. You should understand the videos. And if you have any doubt, please ask through the WhatsApp. Okay, children? Thank you. Bye.